Okay, so once I shot my first roll of film, I'm going to want to develop it. And the way this works is that you need a developing tank because right now the film is inside the case right here and it's light tight. So it's if the moment it gets subjected to light, then it'll be exposed and then it's ruined. So I can't just take it out and develop it. What I'm going to have to do is I'm going to have to take out this film and put it in one of these developing tanks. And this is something you need to do either in a changing bag or in a completely light tight, completely dark room. So what I do usually is I use a room in our building. It's a bathroom and it's just completely dark when the door is shut. There's no window, nothing, and so that's what I do. So in complete darkness, what you do is you have your film like so. You're gonna have to open it. What I do is I use a pocket knife, the can opener. There are also proper film openers that you can use to do this. Really doesn't matter. I mean, I'm just doing this for a demonstration purpose. So what happens is I have the film here, and I guess it's important to wash your hands so they're not greasy or anything. Just, I mean, these parts of the film are anyways the ones that are usually overexposed because they're the beginning of the roll. So it doesn't really matter if you get your hands on them. Then I'm just going to cut it off like so. So it's ready to load onto this spool. The tank I'm using is a Paterson tank, and they have a auto load system, and it works quite well. And I've used the Jobo before, but I prefer the system. I think it's easier. So you just load it up in here. And a little trick is when I do this in darkness, I try to. It's very easy because you just have to feel where these ends are. And then you have your film like so. You just feed the first part. You can drop your film, and then you can start the loading process. And this goes quite quickly with one of these, so. Yeah, and once the roll is completed, I'm just gonna hold it like so and carefully cut off that last bit. And then load up the film so it's wound up completely. And yeah, and then you put it in your developing tank. And once it's inside here, you put this on, now it's completely light tight, and I can start pouring in the chemicals. So that's going to be the next step. Okay, so once you've loaded your film, you're going to have to prepare your chemistry. And in your chemistry, there are four main ingredients. The first ingredient is your developer, which will develop your film. Then you have your stop bath, which will stop the film from developing, otherwise it would overexpose, overdevelop. And your fixer, which will keep everything in place, if you want to say it simply. And finally, you have your anti-static wetting agent, which will just make your film dry properly and it will give it a proper shine. So I'm going to be using Kodak HC110 for my development, and I'm going to start mixing the solution right now. I'm using the dilution A, which is basically a mix of 1 to 15. And I'm going to be posting all the times at the bottom so you can see exactly what kind of mix I'm making. Obviously, a good tip to have if you're working with all this chemistry, it's good to use gloves because this chemistry is dangerous, and if you get it in your fingers and lands in your mouth or in your eyes, you might have to go to the doctor. So it's good protecting yourself if you want to. So yeah, this mix that I'm making right here is the dilution A, which is a very strong dilution, and it's basically a mixture of 1 to 15, I'm sorry. So since I'm developing four rolls of film, I'm not going to be filling up my tank completely because this is a 5 film tank for 35 millimeters. So I'm just going to make the mix for four films. So in my case, that's going to be 73 milliliters of developer. Very important that you close this properly to prevent excess amounts of air form inside because that will kill your developer over time. So this is where I'm going to put my final mix. It's very important that you follow the instructions, the technical details of every film. So I'm developing everything at 20 degrees Celsius. Okay, so my final mix, the complete volume, since this is not completely full, it's only four tanks, is going to be 1,160 milliliters. So I'm just going to pour this right here. Okay, you see, since this is a pretty thick fluid, I'm going to put in the water first here to get my mix, and then I'm going to put some in here just to get everything out. Okay, so my developer is ready. I'm just going to put this right here. Next is the stop bath. Okay, so my stop bath is ready. And then the final mix that I'm going to make is the fixer, but I already have that prepared because from all the liquids, all the chemicals that you can that you use, the fixer is the one thing that you can reuse a couple of times. So I already have a prepared fix right here from my last developing session. So I'm just going to leave this right here and I'm prepared. Usually what I do is I have, just to be super secure, I have my chemistry aligned. So there's some sort of system. So I know first thing is my developer, then is my stop, then is my fix. And here is my film. So the thing that I like to do is I use this app and it's called Digital Truth, and where it's by Digital Truth, and it's the Massive Dev Timer. And it's a very simple way to just to keep time of everything. I mean, some people don't like to use this. Some people just have a timer. And for me, the simplest thing is this, because the technical data is all right and the app works pretty good. So I'm just going to be using this just to have everything timed. So what you do basically in the app is you select exactly how much dilution and everything you have, what kind of film you're using, you put in the details, and then the mix will be made. And it will tell you exactly what kind of time you need to develop at. Okay, so when I'm ready to develop, I have all my things here. I'm going to press start on the app, and then the timer will start. So what I'm going to do is I can open this because this is fine, this is Liketide, and I'm going to pour in my developer. And what I like to do is, while I wait for the agitation period, so what you do is you put the film inside and then there's a different time of agitation for every film. So right now, while the film is resting and I don't have to agitate, I just try to clean up so I'm being as efficient as possible. Okay, and another thing that's important is while you're agitating, I'm actually slightly rotating the tank a few times. So as I agitate, the mixture gets moved around evenly. Okay, and when the process is, it's about to be finished, and it's going to ring. And what I'm going to do is I'm just going to pour it into the toilet, because that's the safest way just to get rid of the chemicals. Okay, and then the next thing is just to put in the stop bath. And like I said, that's just going to stop the developer from working. Okay, we'll see. Okay, and so once the stop bath is out, I have my fixer right here. gonna put that inside now. Just make sure that's closed properly and continue the timer. Okay, and then the final step will be once the timer is finished here, I'm going to pour this back into my fixture because I've only used this twice, so I can easily reuse it again. Then I'm going to wash the film, and that's very important that you just wash the film with warm water, not too warm, around 20 degrees would be ideal. And then wash the film for around 10 minutes just to get all the chemicals out of it. So that's one more step of purely washing the film. So I'm going to do that just in a second. So right now I just poured the fixer back in here because I'm gonna reuse it another time. Just put that back in here with my other chemistry. And now what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna wash the film in water. I can open this now, it's safe to open this. The film is not film light sensitive anymore. Listen. So, and the final step is just to put in the anti-static solution, and that's just going to be inside for around a minute. I wouldn't leave it inside for more than a minute because there's some chemistry involved that you don't want to keep it inside for too long. And then once that's finished, if you have one of these film dryers, you just take out the film and you dry it with this. And then usually the best thing to do is just let it dry overnight. Okay, so this is done, and I'm just going to pour this out. And that's it, and then that's your magic moment. Your film should be ready.